Now there is very important topic that always being asked in your company interviews, how to check serializability, whether the particular schedule given to you is conflict serializable or not, and how do you going to test that? And this particular question is always been asked in your practical examination in YVAS. Okay, how to test serializability? Test serializability or schedule serializable or not, we are going to use the precedence graph. We are going to use the concept of graph, and you already studied how to design a graph in discrete mathematics or in previous subjects also. Okay, a graph is a set of vertices and edges, set of edges, right? So precedence graph is a directed graph. Always it is a directed graph where the vertices are the transaction names and the edges are being labeled by the some values. So suppose transaction, if you see this particular graph given here, there are two transactions, T1 and T2. T1 is performing a read operation on data item X before T2 perform anything on data item X. Then we will draw an arc from transaction T1 to T2. Suppose transaction T2 performs read operation on data item Y before transaction T1 performs read operation on data item Y or write operation on data item Y. It means that T1 accesses the data item Y first. That's why an arc goes from T2 to T1. Right. We draw an arc from Ti to Tj if two transaction conflict and Ti accesses data item on which the conflict arose earlier. It is which of the which transaction performs read or write operations that will going to be initial vertex, and destination vertex would be the another transaction which perform a read and write operation on that same data item. So here T1 is accessing X before T2. Similarly, T2 accesses Y before T1. So there is an arc from T1 to T2, and there is one more arc from T2 to T1. And we can say that a particular schedule is serializable or not by the test of precedence graph. If the graph consists of a cycle like this, then we can say that this particular schedule is not conflict serializable schedule. It is that whenever you design a graph for a given schedule, if there is any cycle exist in between a graph, then we can consider that particular schedule as not conflict serializable schedule, right? And if there is no cycle inside the graph, then that graph particular schedule is considered as conflict serializable. Let us see another example. Now this schedule, suppose there are 5 transactions happening simultaneously, concurrently. Here, there are certain data items like X, Y, Z, U, V, and W. Right? In transaction schedule, this particular schedule, T2 is performing first operation, that is on data item X. Right? Now we have to look for another set of transactions which perform write X on data item X. But if you see, we checked all the instructions and we do not find any transaction which perform write operation or read operation on data item X. So we don't draw any arc from a transaction T2 for data item X to some other transaction. Now let us move to the another instruction into this screen, that is read Y instruction here. If T1 perform read Y instruction, let us check in another transaction. Is there any transaction that perform read or write operation on data item Y? So we have here, that is transaction T2. Means T1 is accessed before transaction T2 happens. That's why we need to draw an arc from T1 to T2. Here there is an arc which goes from T1 to T2. Correct. Let us also check again. T1 also perform a read Z operation, third operation we are checking now. A read Z operation in transaction T1. Let us check in another transaction. Is there any transaction which perform write Z operation or read Z operation after that? So we have one more here, that is T3. That's why an arc goes from transaction T1 to T3. and R goes from director arrow goes from transaction T1 to T3. Correct here. Now let us check the fourth instruction, that is read V into the schedule. T5 is performing read V. Are there any instructions which perform or works on the same data item? There are no transactions which works on data item V. That's why we draw T5, but there is no arc which goes from to T5 to any other transaction. Now let us take the another instruction. Next instruction is read W. It means that W is accessed by T5 transaction. Check any other transaction works on the same data item, and there is no other transaction works on the same data item W. So we leave this particular instruction. There is no conflict in between this. Read W, no problem here. Now go to this read Y operation in transaction X. So we already considered it before. There is T1 to T2. There is an arc. Right? Now there is another instruction, say read U operation. Is there any another transaction which perform read or write operation on U? No, so we skip this also. There is an arc from T3 to T4. It means that T3 is working on data item Z, and are there any another transaction which works on data item Z after this particular instruction into the schedule? Before me, it is after, right? So after this, are there any instructions? Yes. If you go to T4, there is a read Z operation. It means that this Z value is accessed by transaction T3 before T4. That's why an arc goes from T3 transaction vertex to T4 into this graph. Similarly, there is an arc from T2 to T4, because you can see this particular transaction T2 working on data item Y, and then later on, are there any transaction which works on that particular transaction data item? Yes, we have T4, that is perform the read Y operation here. That's why an arc goes from T2 to T4. So this is the arc which goes from T2 to T4. And I think we have covered all the data items, and we have considered all the possibilities of an arc which goes from one transaction to another transaction, and we obtain, suppose this particular graph, we obtain this graph, then we have to decide whether this graph is a cyclic graph or a cyclic graph, and this particular schedule is conflict serializable or not conflict serializable. So please write your answer in the chat box. Is this schedule is conflict serializable or not? Is this particular graph is having a cycle or not? Please write your answer quickly in the chat box. Transaction T1 and then T2 gets performed. Suppose T1 to T2 and R goes. T1 to T3 goes when T1 performs something before T3. Similarly, T4 and T4. Right? And T5 is not connected to any other vertices in this particular graph. And this is a directed graph. You can see, if you can see it carefully, is there any cycle in this graph? Anyone can say that there is no cycle, because if you see, cycle will be there only when initial position and this ending position is same. If you are able to reach initial and destination position as, by any path, then there is a cycle, right? So here there is no cycle. You can't come to T1 again. You can go from T1 to some other vertex, but you can't come to T1 again into this. That's why there is no cycle. Even if it looks like a cycle, T5 is not connected to this particular graph. So I can say that this is a cyclic graph. There is no cycle. And if there is no cycle in the graph, you can directly say that this particular schedule is not conflict serializable schedule. Is it okay, student? It is not a conflict serializable schedule. And the answer given by all the students is correct.